Hi people, and welcome to a lesson on angles in an isosceles triangle. Now today's lesson we'll be able to find missing angles in an isosceles triangle, so it's more specific and it's a bit trickier than the regular triangles. But as I was saying in the previous video, angles in a triangle is still the same, 180 degrees, as we will explore. Now, keywords will remain the same, as are the real life links and the equipment required. So let's dive straight in. So what we have over here is photos of isosceles triangles. Now, the important part to note is that the base angles in an isosceles triangle are equal, something that you should know, but if you don't, what I'm saying is that the base in an isosceles triangle, the angles that are associated with that base, is our base, as I'm pointing over here, these are equal, and you can know it's an isosceles triangle by these little lines that you have that they may have in them. You can know it's an isosceles triangle when two of the angles are the same and two of the sides are the same. So this side and this side are the same. There's no measurements, but you know why I know? Because of this line over here. Okay? Just like over here, this line and this line. When these two connect with the base, the angle that they create are also the same. So an isosceles triangle, the properties are that you have two straight lines that are the same and two same angles. Now, the reason why I'm telling you these lines are so important is because sometimes they won't actually give you measurement, but you need to be able to spot these little lines. Because you have one line over here and one line over there, and it means that this line is equal to this line. And in the isosceles triangle's case, when the lines do meet with the base of the triangle, the angle created is also the same. Okay? And the final thing I'd like to say is that sometimes triangles, they won't have these lines, but they'll have two same angles, and they may ask you what type of triangle is this. And if you can see two same angles, then you should know that the triangle is an isosceles. Okay, so when two same base angles, it's an isosceles triangle. So let's have a look at an example. Let's just say that we were told to calculate the size of angle A. Okay, so let me draw the angles. Now, we're told that these two lines are equal. Yeah, we have this line over here. We have an angle over here called B. We have an angle over here called A. And we have this at 65 degrees. Now, usually what we were doing before was we were just covering up two to find the third. But now we have two missing angles and only one piece of information. Now, the important thing over here is that we have this line over here and this line over here. What is the base associated with these lines? That's right. It's this over here, isn't it? In this triangle, the base is over here. And it connects these two same length lines. Therefore, this angle over here is a part of the angle. No, it's also the same as the angle over here due to the properties of a triangle. So automatically, I can tell you that A is 65 degrees. I'll add that in. A is 65 degrees. Well, now we can use the same method I've been using. Cover these two up, and we can work out B. Okay, so if you cover these two up, basically, we take these two away from 180, because remember, angles in a triangle still add up to 180. If we were to take these two away, we'd end up with our B. These two added together is 130. 180 take away 130 would give us 50 degrees. So our angle over here is 50 degrees. Therefore, B is 50 degrees. Okay? So, key things to note. The lines, these are the lines that cross these edges. It denotes that the sides are the same length. And from there, if there's a base and the two same length, we know it's an isosceles. Therefore, if this is 65 degrees, this is also 65 degrees. Okay then, so let's have a look at another triangle then. So we have this triangle over here. I'll draw it out. Okay, and we have these two lines going through. And we have X and we have Y. Now, we are told that this angle over here is 130 degrees. How can we work out X and Y? Well, this is actually not as hard as it looks. What we need to understand is that these two lines, we know that it means that these lines are equal. Therefore, X is equal to Y. Or I'll use X how I've been writing it normally, so I'll write X is equal to Y. I'll get rid of that. Okay? So these two angles are the same length. So, if I were to cover this angle up over here, we still don't know these two angles, but what we do know is that this angle is the same as this angle. So, if we were to subtract this 130 over here, whatever these two add together, since they're both the same thing, we can half whatever the number we get when we subtract 130 from 180. So let's just do the math and we'll see. So we have 180, we subtract 130, we get left with 50 degrees. So that basically means that this angle and this angle are 50 degrees together. Why? Because this is 130 degrees. We've taken that away, haven't we? So we still have 50 degrees to play with, and we have two angles that are split between that 50 degrees. Now, luckily, we know this is an isosceles triangle. Therefore, these two angles are the same. So all we need to do is just divide our 50 degrees by 2, and that would give us 25 degrees, because remember, these are isosceles triangles. So if this is 25 degrees and this is 25 degrees, that's 50. Add 130, we get our 180. And what did I use? I used these lines over here, and I used the fact that the angles are the same. Because if I didn't know the angles were the same, then how would I split this 50 degrees up? Because I can't split it into two. I can only split them into two equal 25, because they are the same angles. Right, I want you to have a go at this question now. Use the properties of an angle, and of a triangle in an isosceles triangle specifically, and work out B and C. Once you are ready to work it out, unpause the video. As usual, of course, you're going to pause the video while you're doing it. And as you unpause it, I should be going through it as well. So hopefully you've had a go. I'm going to now go through the question. Now, this is actually quite simple compared to some of the questions, but we'll go through it. So let me just write our things out. Now, first thing, these lines that go through here, here's our base. Okay, so automatically I can tell you that B is going to be equal to 80 degrees, because this is an isosceles triangle, because we have two same length lines. And if the base is here, these two angles are also going to be the same. That means that B is also going to be equal to 80 degrees. Okay, so if B is equal to 80, so if this angle over here is 80 degrees, and this angle over here is 80 degrees, well, 80 at 80 is 160. We take away 160 from the total 180, that will give us our C, which you should have gotten to be 20 degrees. Right, so now that you've done all of that, here are some questions for you to try. If you're in set 4 or 3, I want you to have a go at all of these questions. If you're in set 5, you should be able to get up to at least question 8. Okay? That's where it gets slightly trickier, especially onwards. But you should be able to get to question 8 and push yourself further towards all of them. Once you are done, of course, upload your work at a class chart for your teacher to mark.